What I want to do in this video is to actually use a graphing calculator, get some experience on the calculator itself for graphing some of these quadratics and actually figuring out the roots visually by looking at those graphs. So the first equation I want to find the x-intercept for is y is equal to negative 3x squared plus 4x minus 1. So we're just going to go straight to the calculator. Get our TI-85 out here. And there are obviously better things you can use, especially on your computer, that are going to be much more visually interesting and in color and even faster. But many of us have a TI-85 at our disposal. And the TI-85 hasn't changed much, actually, since I was in high school, or TI-83 or whatever else there's out there, TI-92. And this will at least give you a sense of how to use it, because this is what you have, and how to analyze the graph once you are able to graph it. I already turned it on, so let's input this graph right here. So we click on graph, and then we'll click on this F1 tells us to pick this option right here, this y of x. Right? So they're saying y is a function of x. Y is indeed a function of x. So let's click there. And then that's going to be negative 3x. Let's see, where is the variable? There's the x variable, x squared plus 4x minus 1. There is our function. Now let's graph it. So we want to pick this choice up here. So to pick the second choice, so notice, if you want to pick any of these choices on the bottom row, you can just punch in these numbers. But if you want to pick the choice that's above, you could press second and then press that. And the second tells you to pick the thing that's right above that. So I'll pick the thing in the yellow, essentially. So I'll do second. And I'm selecting the graph option. The graph option. When I was in high school, this was all very fancy stuff. But now, compared to pretty much most cell phones, this is pretty archaic. But it gets the job done. Now, let's zoom in, because I really can't see the zeros that well. So let me zoom here. I like to use the box. It just creates we zoom in on a certain area that I can define. So I'll select the box. And then I select where I want to start the box for using the arrow keys. Press Enter. That tells it to start the box. And then I can zoom in using the box. I define the box. And when I have a box I like, I press Enter. And it'll redefine the range of x and y values that it calculates the graphing function. Now, I want to figure out what these x-intercepts are. So I'm going to use a trace function. And the trace function is just going to walk along this graph. So let me hit second, trace. And now I'm walking along this graph. As I go to the right, it just increments the x value. We're getting closer and closer to y is equal to 0. And it looks like it happens right at about 1. Right as I cross 1, I'm crossing y is equal to 0. Right? Y is a very small positive number here. And then it goes to becoming a less small, but still a small negative number right as we cross 1. It didn't evaluate it directly at x is equal to 1. But I think that's a pretty good approximation. We can even try it out in our equation. Let's try it out. If x is equal to 1, let me write it this way. Y of 1, if we write y as a function of 1, this is going to be equal to negative 3 times 1 squared plus 4 times 1 minus 1. So this is equal to negative 3 plus 4 minus 1, which is indeed 0. So the point x is equal to 1, y is equal to 0 is definitely on the graph, and this is one of our x-intercepts. Let's see if we can figure out the other one using our calculator. So let's see, we need to figure out this other point right here. Let's get the zoom box going. Actually, let's try just to trace there. Oh, scrolling all the way. It looks like it's around 0.33. Looks like it's around 0.33. I suspect it's close to 1/3, but let me zoom in a little bit better. So I'm going to click graph again, click on zoom. I'm going to use the box again. And then let me do the top left corner of the box. I'm going to zoom in really narrowly on that point right there. Really, really zoom in. So it's around 0.33 that I want to zoom in. So that's going to be the beginning of my box. And then let me go right below the y-axis, and then go right above 0.33. And so it's really zoomed in on that y-intercept right there. So now if I trace it, I really should be able to figure out what that value is. So let me do second and trace, and keep scrolling. So it's a little bit more than 0.33. It looks like it's really approaching 0.333333, which is 1/3. Looks like it's 0.3 repeating. Then we're getting to very, very small y value. So it looks like 1/3. So let's try out 1/3 and see if we got the right answer. So if we have y of 1/3 is equal to -3 times 1/3 squared plus 4 times 1/3 minus 1. This is equal to -3 times 1/9 is -1/3. This is +4/3. And then minus 1 or -1, how you depending on how you view it, is the same thing as -3/3. So this is going to be -1 + 4 - 3, all of that over 3, which is indeed 0. So we also have the x-intercept. X is equal to 1/3, y is equal to 0. Let's do another one. Let's say we have 1/2. Let's see. Let's say we have y is equal to 1/2 x squared minus 2x plus 3. Let's see if we can get its roots or the zeros of this equation where it intersects the x-axis. So let's get our calculator back. And we're going to have to zoom out of this thing. So let me do zoom. See, I don't know. I think I can do the previous zoom. Well, the previous zoom is still a little bit not too zoomed in. Let me do the previous zoom before that. Oh, I guess it keeps zoom previous. And then if I do another zoom, oh, it just keeps alternating between the zooms. So maybe I have to go, maybe I have to clear out. I am not an expert at this. All right. So let me just input my new graph. So it's 1/2 x squared. I could write that as 0.5 x squared minus 2x plus 3. And then I want to graph this. So let me second and graph it. Oh, it's still on that super zoomed in version. So let me zoom out. Zoom. What's zoom? Maybe, oh, there you go. Zoom standard. That resets it. There you go. That's all I had to do. The standard zoom. So you see. Let's see, where does it intersect the x-axis? Well, it doesn't intersect the x-axis. It just goes down here and then keeps going up. So this quadratic function right here will have no x-intercepts. I mean, you can see it graphically here. It does not intersect the x-axis. So if you're trying to solve the equation, 1/2 x squared minus 2x plus 3 is equal to 0, what you're essentially trying to do is say, what x values give me y is equal to 0 here? We just graphed it. It never intersected the x-axis. It just did something like this. It never. So it never equaled y is equal to 0. So this right here will have no real solutions. And I use the word real in the mathematical sense. There are no real number solutions. We'll see in not too far off in the future that there are things called complex numbers. And those can be solutions to quadratics that don't intersect the x-axis, at least in kind of the real domain. Now let's do one more of these. Let's say we have x squared plus 6x plus 9 is equal to 0. And we should actually be able to factor this in our head. What two numbers add up to 6? And when you multiply them, you get 9. It probably jumps out of your head. It's 3 and 3. So this is x plus 3 times x plus 3 is equal to 0. Or, I mean, we just have to use one of these. X plus 3 is equal to 0. Subtract 3 from both sides. X is equal to -3. So this has 1, 0. So how do you think this is going to look if it only intersects the x-axis at exactly one point? Well, the best guess is that one point is going to be the vertex. So let's graph it just to verify for ourselves. So let me clear this one out. And we have x squared plus 6x plus 9, and we want to graph it. And there you go. It just, the vertex is right at x is equal to negative 3, y is equal to 0. It just hits it right over there. So our intuition was correct. And just as a bit of review, and I should have pointed this out when I was showing you the other graphs, notice this has a positive coefficient on x squared. It is upward opening. The second problem we did also had a positive coefficient. It didn't intersect the x-axis, but it was also upward opening. And if you rewind this video to the very first problem we did, you saw it had a negative coefficient, and it also had a downward opening parabola, or downward opening U-shape. Well, anyway, hopefully you found this little practice with the graphing calculator helpful.